the beat.
Hey everybody, Sean McInnes here at Gamescom 2011, where I've got Glenn Schofield here from Sledgehammer to tell us all about the new survival Spec Ops mode in Modern Warfare 3. Glenn, thanks a lot.
Hi Sean, thanks for having me.
Yeah, my pleasure, definitely. So let's talk about survival a little bit. This is a new feature for the Modern Warfare series. Yeah, absolutely. So let's talk about how this idea came about. When did you guys decide that you guys wanted to do something different with Spec Ops mode?
I think right away. You know, we knew that we had something really good, and you know, people had said, hey, felt a little tacked on the last game, but they loved it. So we wanted to really integrate it into the game a lot more, and that's what we did.
All right, so how do you go about designing Spec Ops mode, which is, you know, it relies very heavily on those sort of like the signature unlocks and the perks, right, and the right. Persistence from the multiplayer side of Call of Duty. How do you go about adapting that to survival? What do you keep the same? What do you change?
Well, we kept a lot of it the same so that people would feel comfortable, you know, playing in there and then going into multiplayer. That was the whole idea, is to sort of have a step for people. But it is pretty hardcore mode in itself, you know. So what we wanted to do is, you know, kind of have the missions that, some of the missions that are in multiplayer playing here, so that you got to know the maps, but also that you got used to the ranking up and the leveling up and buying new weapons and XP and stuff like that.
Now, anytime you're talking about one of these survival modes, the big thing to keep in mind is just making sure that you have that nice, solid, sort of like steady progression of difficulty. Can you give us a sense of how the difficulty progresses in survival mode? What types of enemies that you'll encounter as you survive more and more?
Well, you get dogs and helicopters, and then you have dogs with C4 and guys with C4 and juggernauts and just wave after wave, and it gets really hard. So you really have to, it gets hard quickly. So you've got to rank up, you've got to, put new weapons on, grab new weapons, and upgrade them as well.
And there is that currency system where you're sort of like you're earning cash on the fly. Can you give us a sense of how that works?
Well, I mean, you're getting the cash so that you can, the more kills you get, you know, of course, you're going to get the cash. You're going to go to one of these areas where you can either get weapons, you can get ammo, you can get even Predator missiles and things like that. You saw when we were playing, we put down some turrets. So there's all kinds of stuff that you can grab in there and, you know, just help yourself out. I mean, you can even call in a squad of Delta.
All right. Now, cool. Now, while we're on the subject of Spec Ops, you guys are also carrying over the mission-based Spec Ops stuff from Modern Warfare 2. What are you guys doing with the missions in there to really make them stand out from the campaign?
Well, I mean, the first thing is that it is, you know, co-op. Now, you can play the single player, so it's kind of neat to get in there. So we have to design them both for single player and, you know, co-op. And co-op is also, you know, online or split screen. And the idea was, you know, we knew people had played it before. We needed to kind of, you know, go another step higher. So you and I played one that was, you know, sort of, okay, I'm going to get my feet wet. I understand what it is to be a juggernaut, which is pretty cool, right, to play that. And then they get a little bit more intricate as we go.
Time very much. Go ahead and remind everybody out there, the few people who don't know, when Modern Warfare 3 is going to be out in stores.
November 8th, 2011.
All right. There you guys have it. Modern Warfare 3 Spec Ops here at Gamescom 2011.